हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू आर डूइंग वेल। सो इन दिस लेक्चर विल बी जस्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ टू वे कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन अ क्लाइंट एंड अ सर्वर। सो टिल नाउ वी नो दैट व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज अ सॉकेट, हाउ इट इज क्रिएटेड, व्हाई इट इज यूज्ड, ओके, हाउ द कनेक्शन इज बीइंग एस्टैब्लिश्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस सॉकेट बिटवीन अ क्लाइंट मशीन एंड अ सर्वर मशीन, हाउ वन वे कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन अ क्लाइंट एंड अ सर्वर इज देयर, ओके, हाउ दिस इज अचीव्ड। So this particular things we have just created and we have implemented with the help of programs. So now in this particular lecture I'll be just showing that how a two-way communication is there. So a client is sending a particular request to the server and the server is responding to this particular request, and again a server is sending a message to the client that will be displayed on the client screen. So we can say a message, okay, a message is in transmission, you can say, okay, a message is from client to server and another a respond message is from server to client. So this will be a two-way communication. Two-way means server is also now sending the message to the client. So it means that server has also its output stream enabled, okay. So the output stream of the server will be responsible to send the message to the input stream of the client. So an effective communication will be there. So we will just create a class, okay. So this, the name of the class is now demo client 2, okay, and I'll just create a socket, okay. Till this point it must be clear to you now that why we are creating the socket and what we'll do in this socket. So we'll just create a socket, new socket, and inside this we'll pass the IP, that is the local host, and the 2665, for example, the port for the server to which it will respond, okay. And now we'll just open, okay, the output stream over the print writer for the client, so that the client will send the message over this particular stream. So I'll use print writer, that is a very important and powerful writer, over the output stream. PW is equal to new print writer, and inside this what will pass, will pass, what will pass inside this print writer, will pass sk, that is the sockets dot get output stream. So now this stream has been opened, okay, this output stream has been opened over this server object, that is over this socket, sorry, over this sockets we have just opened this output stream, okay, and we'll just make it true so that they will be auto flush. So now we'll just write a message, okay. So this will be just similar to that we have created, okay, the program that we have created earlier, that is the one-way communication. So we'll just write pw dot print ln client hello server, okay. And we'll just close it, pw dot close catch exception e, and we'll just close this, class is closed, and we'll just, okay. So now what we'll do, we'll just create, this will be saved, control s, this will be saved as demo client 2 dot java, okay. So now we'll create a server, so we'll just copy this, we'll just create a server also, okay. So we'll just give it a name, server 2, okay, and inside this we'll create a server socket, okay, server socket ss is equal to new server socket, and inside this will pass the port number that we have given here, that is 2665, okay. So just will print the message system dot out dot print ln server is waiting for the client, this message we have, okay, just pass here, okay. So now we'll have to accept this and we have to return a socket object. Okay, so we'll just return a socket object. Socket object will be returned when this SS, okay, server socket will accept this request. So this is the method that will be invoked with the help of the server sockets object. Now what we'll do, we'll just print a line. I'm just writing it so that, okay, there should be no confusion to you. So I'm writing each and every step so that there must be no confusion. So I'm just writing connection step list. Okay, so now the connection has been established. So now what we have to do, we have to open the input stream, okay, for that particular server. So now we'll just write input stream reader ISR is equal to new input stream reader, and inside this what we'll pass, we'll pass the get input stream. Okay, that will return an stream over the socket object. So now we'll just wrap it inside the buffered reader. Buffered reader br is equal to new buffered reader, and we'll just wrap it so that this particular data must be read in the form of characters efficiently. Okay, now we'll just write br dot read line, and it will return a string, s. So till now this program is just exactly the same that we have created for a single way communication between a client and the server. Okay, so now this will be message is plus, we'll just append this s. Okay, so till now it must be clear to you. So now what our task is, now this has been read by the server. Now the server will also respond. Now the server should also, okay, use its output stream to send message to the client. So what we'll do, we have to just copy these two lines. Okay, so we have to just copy these two lines. Okay, exactly these two lines over here. Because now what we are doing, we are just, okay, now the server is responding. Okay, responding server is responding through its output stream. Okay, so I will just print this. I'll just paste this, okay, these lines, that is print writer PR. Now we have to write this is exactly same, there is no correction. And here what we will write, this must be from server. Okay, so this must be from server, because server is sending that hello client, okay, I am good. Okay, so this message will be displayed to client. So what we'll do now, we will just close it, pw.close, and catch exception e, and this is completed. Okay, now this, if this particular output stream will be created for the client, then this client must be in a position to read from this output stream with the help of the input stream. So what we'll do, we'll write the, we have to open the input stream for the client also. So what we'll do, we'll just copy these two lines, okay, for the client. Now the client must be in a position. So now what we'll do, the client is reading from its input stream. Okay, because a socket has two streams, one is the input stream and other is the output stream. So if a message is floating from one stream, then the other stream must be able to read this message. Okay, so two streams must be open if there is two-way communication. So what we'll do, we'll just print this input stream reader for the client, okay, and this is okay. And now what we'll do, we'll just write dr.readline and it will be string, okay, s1, and we will just write here system.out.println. So this is from server, okay. So message is plus, we'll just append this message, okay, and the connection will be closed. Connection I have closed here, okay, so there should be no problem. So this is completed. Now we'll just save this, okay. This will be demo server 2.java, okay. So this is server I have created and client I have created. So now we'll just try to run this. First we'll try to execute server and let's check if there are any errors or not. So java c demo server 2, okay, its I is missing. So server has been, okay, successfully compiled, and now we'll just execute it. It is waiting for the client. So now we will try to run the client. So I'm just opening the client from here, okay. This is the client window. Black window is for client. Java C demo client 2.java. So there are some errors. Okay, this is capital. This is the method. I have made it small. Okay, and I just put this close method, okay, at the end so that all the connections are closed. And socket also I'm just closing this, okay. So now we will try to run this. Let's see. So it has been compiled. Now I'll execute the client, java demo client 2. So as soon as, okay, I'll just hit the enter button, you will just see the message will be displayed at the server side, okay, that has been sent by the client, as well as the message will be displayed on this, okay, console that will be thrown, that will be sent by the server as a response, okay. So here you can see, okay, both the messages are there. Connection, after the connection has been established, message from the client to server is hello server, and at the same time the server is also responding to the client that message from the server is hello client, I am good. So there is a two-way communication, okay. So this two-way communication is with the help of these two streams, that is the input stream and the output stream that we have written in both the client and the server machine. So you must practice this, and you just try to, okay, create a program now that is a chat server in which client and server are continuously sending the messages, okay. So if one message is from client, then again the server will reply to that message, again the client will respond, server will reply, and so on. So a message transfer will take place between client to server. So try to create a chat server. You know that all the chat servers, okay, use this socket, okay. Internal socket programming is working internally in all the chat based sites that you are using. So our socket is executing, okay, there is a client socket, there is a server socket, connection has been established, and now the transfer of messages are taking place. So just practice, okay, this concept and try to create as an assignment, okay, a chat server. So the concept is now, okay, it is clear to you. So please write the programs on your own, and you just create a program that client is sending, for example, a number, okay, 4, and the number, the factorial of that number is being sent by the server machine to the client machine. So you must try to execute this small program so that you will be more confident, okay, in creating these program like these. So thanks, stay healthy.